Congresswoman Michele Bachmann officially launches her 2012 presidential campaign today. Pat Caddell says we could be seeing it again. No, they love to make fun of her. They're obsessed by her. What do you make of that?
Well, it's the, you know, inside the beltway media culture, the mainstream media culture, which, and I think the attitude, first of all, she's a woman, so therefore, and a Republican woman, so therefore she automatically falls under the category of someone to be dismissed or derided, and they like to make her out to be an idiot. She's not. She's a very smart woman. She has was a tax lawyer. She has a great personal story. And, you know, sometimes she speaks metaphorically. Well, if you're in that category, you know, if you're the president, if you're a Barack Obama and you say there are 57 states, no one pays attention. But if you're her or Sarah Palin or someone they don't like, any mistake you make gets blown up. And we saw some of that yesterday, by the way.
But indeed. I'm wondering, you know, our colleague Chris Wallace has gotten in a lot of heat.
Yes, he should too. And by the way, and I am he has no bigger admirer than me.
No, and
but
I.
Yesterday, he really.
That comment. I mean, for those who aren't aware, this is what caused all the hullabaloo. This is from Chris Wallace yesterday.
Are you a flake?
Well, I think that would be insulting to say something like that because I'm a serious person.
But you understand when I say that's what the rap on you is.
Well, what I would say is that I am 55 years old. I've been married 33 years. I'm not only a lawyer, I have a postdoctorate degree in federal tax law from William & Mary.
All right, well, what Chris was doing was, prior to that, going through the litany of misquotes and the statements from her, and he even later said that how he phrased that might have been an error. But what did you make of that?
But I made out of it, what I made out of it is this what they all say in the cocktail circuit. The Republican leadership doesn't like her. She's an outsider. Look, as I keep saying, we have a country in which we have a political class that 15-20% of the country believes in something, 80% the other way. She's from the 80%. She's to be denigrated. And Chris, who, as I said, I admire greatly, but he really, and he apologized, I guess, formally. But it wasn't just that. If I had been her, you want to talk about pushback, when he went through all the things, what I called the 15 minutes of gotcha, I would have said, by the way, now that we spent all your time doing gotcha questions, you mind if I say something about why I'm running for president and what's really important in America as opposed to what's important to you in Washington? This is what candidates don't do. They should push back. I did see Chris Christie doing that yesterday. He lets nobody push him around. And candidates
have
to do that.
So are you saying that Republicans are in the... Admix, she is the prominent female candidate running for it, the only one so
right.
far.
But they did. Look what they did to Sarah Palin.
Is there going to be a double standard?
Well, of course there's a double standard. They've tried to make her out to be. When I first met Michele Bachmann at a conference and talked to her, I assumed that she was what the media made her out to be, Sarah Palin light. And I said, you're not stupid. You're really smart. It was amazing to me. Now, I may not agree with her on all the issues. I don't.
But I've heard from even comedians who love the fact that she's in the race and they... And I've heard when they said the same, well, remember back in 1980, we hope Ronald Reagan runs and he's the nominee
right. well,
against Jimmy Carter.
Tell me about that.
Right.
Yes,
so why is there this fixation with people who they say we shouldn't be fixated on?
Because the media has stepped out of its role of being reporting and taken on the role. And I leave Chris out of this. This is not what we do at Fox. He was pushing her as the candidate. But a lot of the media operates on, we support this candidate. Look, they covered up for Barack Obama. He got the lightest treatment, the least in his study than any presidential candidate in modern history has had. We have this pushing back. Candidates got to learn to push back because guess who the country doesn't like? The media. You look at the numbers. John McCain should have pushed back against them in 2008. His failure to do so, and you know why? So many consultants who consult with these campaigns worry about their own careers in Washington. Say, oh, no, you can't touch the media. Well, it's not in the old days where you're attacking somebody that buys ink by the barrel. We have things called television. We have the internet. It is now time for people to challenge the media. If they want to be political players and desert their role in protecting the people and standing up and being the objective forces, then they need to be challenged by candidates. This notion they get to decide who is president and who should not be, what truth people can know and what truth they cannot know, candidates better start pushing back. And Chris Christie shows when you do it, people love it.
Interesting. All right, Pat Caddell, good seeing you again.
Good to see you.
Thank you very much.